Hey everybody, this is Michael yet again, and welcome back to my monster movie reviews focusing on the original Japanese Godzilla films. Now, the second film is one that I actually never saw until it reached home video. Now, of course, here in America, the film was called Gigantus, the Fire Monster, and that's another one that I never actually saw until home video. So, just like the original Godzilla film, which of course is called Gojira, I was introduced to Godzilla through Godzilla, King of the Monsters. Now, that of course wasn't the first Godzilla film that I saw, but King of the Monsters was my first introduction to Godzilla. And then, of course, years later, I would see Gojira. But anyway, Godzilla Raids Again is one of those films that I never saw in its original form until it was released to home video, and that of course is this Godzilla Raids Again. Now, this of course is the classic media version of the film, and that's the back of it. Now, these all come individually, or you can get them in a set of, I believe, 8 films. And here's the inside of it, guys. Which the classic media guys, I gotta give them props, guys. They did a good job on these releases, a very good job. And I mean, you know, what's neat about these films is that they're the original versions of the movie, and they're just you know, great to have, because you're getting basically 2 versions of the film on these discs. Now, this of course has the original Japanese version, and then you have the English dub version. Now, it would have been nice if this had been a 2-disc set and they've included Gigantus, the Fire Monster, but of course that was owned by a different company, so they neglected to include it in this set. Now, I saw this film, like I said, years later, and when I first saw it, what I thought was that, being in black and white, that it reminded me of the original Godzilla. But, you know, the black and white is basically where the similarities end. Where the original Godzilla film was tense, dramatic, dark, and foreboding, a representation of what the people experienced through World War II with the droppings of the atomic bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. A film that had many, many layers, metaphors for so much pain and sorrow. This film was much lighter. Of course, you know, whereas in the original Godzilla film, he was destroyed at the end of the film by the oxygen destroyer, in this movie, Godzilla has returned. And apparently some more radiation has mutated another prehistoric creature and returned not only Godzilla to life, but his opponent in this film, Anguirus. And the two meet up, and as a matter of fact, guys, this is the first film that began all the Godzilla versus so-and-so and so forth and so on. Now, in this film, guys, Godzilla's returned, and he's fighting Anguirus in the film. And, you know, once that battle is over, he, of course, comes to the city. And while at the time, guys, I will say that when I first saw this film, and even watching it as far as, you know, a week ago, some of the monster effects with Godzilla fighting the creature and Godzilla being in the city, I was impressed by it. But then there are those times when you can tell that Godzilla is obviously a very poorly made hand puppet and it looks terrible. But, you know, all gone is basically all those things that made the original film so good. Now, I don't hate Godzilla Raids Again, but it's definitely a step down from the original film, which had compelling characters. I mean, you had Emiko, which played the love interest in the story. Then you had Dr. Yamane, who played the scientist that did not want Godzilla to be destroyed. Then you had the love triangle that had Emiko, Dr. Sarazawa, and Ogata. And you had some characters that were not only believable, but for what they serviced the story, I thought pretty well written. You had some decent people that, you know, you could root for. And even the co-starring actors did a great job of showing the terror and the ferocity of Godzilla and what was going on, the whole situation. Just everything was top-notch in the original Godzilla film. But in this one, One of the failures of the film is the fact that, you know, you just don't have really any good characters that you can wrap your hands around. As a matter of fact, you have two leads, two male characters, and, you know, basically, you just really have, at least for me anyway, I didn't have any connection with the characters. They were very underdeveloped. And, you know, I've said it before and I'll say it again, guys. It's just one of those films where you just want good to win for the sake of good. But Godzilla just, you know, I don't know. After as hard-hitting as the first film was, this one is pretty much just, you know, fluff. It is nowhere near on the level of the second film. And it's a film that, you know, even though they got the actor to come back that plays Dr. Yamane in a scene, even he didn't have the emotional depth that he had in the first film. I mean, as a matter of fact, he just kind of sits there and nods and, you know, just... And, you know, guys, it's just... I don't hate the film, but it's definitely one that I don't have a lot of fondness for, other than the fact that they did introduce Anguirus, who is one of my favorite of the Godzilla monsters. But other than that, it's just a movie that I just don't have a lot of fondness for. I was really disappointed by the film. And I guess instead of being more like the original film, to me it was kind of like a cheap copy, which, you know, is pretty much to be expected since, you know, this film was rushed into production on the success of the original film. Now, the original film came out in 1954, and they actually put this film together and released it by 1955. And the film was a success, despite the fact that critics and fans pretty much didn't really like the film that much. Now, of course, you know, after Godzilla was a big hit, or Gojira, you know, people rushed out to see this movie, and they were just, you know, overall disappointed with the film. It's definitely not one of my favorites. When I actually review the English versions of these films, the English version is actually like many, many more times worse than this one. The English version that was released in America, Gigantus the Fire Monster, I would probably say that film is probably one, if not the worst, of the original Godzilla films that they ever made. It's just terrible. But as it stands, guys, Godzilla Raids Again, basically it's a retread of the same story, other than the fact that he does fight Anguirus in the film, and then he does come ashore and he raids Tokyo again. And of course, they have to figure out how to get rid of the guy. And instead of focusing on, you know, like something serious where you have the military fighting Godzilla or a military commander in charge or some heavy-hitting scientists or something, you have two guys that work in a fishing company. They actually go out and locate schools of fish, and they relay it to fishing boats where they should go and fish. You have these guys actually taking it upon themselves trying to locate Godzilla and deal with Godzilla. As a matter of fact, even the military was working with these guys to make a plan against stopping Godzilla. Yeah. But anyway, Godzilla Raids Again, guys, definitely not one of my favorite in the series. Now, for nostalgic sake, I have it in my collection because it is, you know, the second film featuring Godzilla. And I gotta say too, guys, that, you know, the Godzilla suit that they used in this one, when it's shown from the side, it looks really, really impressive. But from the front, it is the goofiest looking Godzilla suit I have seen. But anyway, I would definitely say check it out, guys. It's probably worth a view. It's one of those films that, you know, I'm not gonna put in and just watch all the time. It's just one of those Godzilla films that, you know, given the fact that, you know, actually... you know, most of the time when Godzilla fights monsters in movies, the monsters don't actually die. But in this one, his opponent actually bites the dust. And definitely got to say that was a surprise. But give it a look, guys, and see what you think. Next up, we have the third Godzilla film in my series of reviews that I'll be discussing, guys. But like I said, this is definitely one that I can't... really recommend, other than the fact that you give it a look. As a matter of fact, guys, like I said, I believe these Classic Media put out a set of these, eight in a box set, that are not really expensive at all. I think you can get them all for like $20, $25. But, you know, they have some decent features on them. They have both English and Japanese version of the film. And, or that Japanese version with the English subtitles in this one. But I would definitely say, you know, buy it, because this is not a bad release of the film at all. Picture quality even looks pretty doggone decent too. But anyway, guys, I'm out of here. Thanks for watching, and I shall see you at the next Godzilla movie review. Godzilla Raids Again.